friend, and welcome again to everyone. Apart from pandemic, we are all safe. We are all safe, and we are all here together to praise our God name, to glorify His name. So we start our topic. The topic name is Stand Firm. Be constant. Be stand firm, because the days are evil. Before we learn, the days are evil actually. So now this pandemic. Many people are, we can listen that how many people are died, they are suffering. So the pandemic is actually for everyone. Yes, the pandemic is not like Christians are out from the pandemic, but Christians are there. Because this pandemic is here, is telling us to stand firm. So we will today go through the topic here, and I will appreciate if there is anything else that we can share, we can ask, okay? So in case of any verses, we can share, we can ask, please go ahead. So okay, welcome. So let's be thankful. So first we start to share something that has been given you reason to rejoice during the past week. Have you faithfully thank God for these blessings? So we will start from, as usual, from, from Brother Hansi.
Okay, then let's start with I thank God for this time, even this time of pandemic, I'm still here, praising God, serving God, worshiping God. So God never leaves me. Mm-hmm. And I'm so thankful that me and my wife, in my marriage life, we are lucky that we experienced in the beginning the hard time. So we have already like trials that we have to overcome. So now I thank God that me and my wife still in we are still stand firm.
Strong.
Yeah. During this time pandemic, it's like 5 months already. We still survive in the grace of God and the blessing of God. So I'm so thankful and that yeah. And I give praise to the Lord in honor. I really want to serve more our Lord.
Amen. Good, brother. Good. Very encouraging. Stephen?
I thank God for good health.
That is good. That is most important now. Really. Brother Sanjeev?
Thanks God. That he gives the life. He protects us from everything, even in this pandemic. So it's not affecting us. That's the big thing, brother. And then for everything, he's always looking after our family and all the people. Still is blessing us. That's big thanks. And hopefully, the God will bless us always.
Continuing, yeah. Yes, amen, brother.
I thank God for everything, especially though we are facing some problem, but still we are strong enough to fight for that. Through blessing, through prayer.
But please.
Yeah. Thanks God for the protection and good health.
That's good. That's good. The same, you have something to thank God.
I thank God that nowadays I'm not tired a lot.
Yes.
Good, God listens to you. God is very faithful.
Yeah, last BS, you pray.
Yeah, God is faithful. God answered.
God is faithful.
I thank God that we're happy.
Wow. That's good.
Yeah. God is moving.
Okay, for me, I thank God that He always answers prayers. Like this week, our visa was released, although Stephen's visa has not been released yet, but I still thank God because He knows everything, what's happening, and He has a purpose for that.
Amen. Yes. Now, Anna?
I'm thankful to our God because before you go to visa, I really pray for your protection, and really God is with us and with you all. So I'm thankful that you safe here in Pupara. You come safe here in Pupara. So I'm thankful for that, and I'm thankful for all the blessings, especially the before yesterday, maybe day before yesterday, I received small blessings from my auntie, and he told me that that is testing only because I don't want to give my full information in account. So he sent actually 3,000 for only testing because I am a hard-headed asper hair. So I'm thankful for that.
God is our provider. He provides from different ways. Okay, Sister Ruby.
I thank to God for the good health, continuous loving, and continuous giving blessing.
Good. Sister.
I thanks to God that we are still alive and healthy, everybody, and we see each other and we have this Bible study today. And I'm really thankful today so much because my husband is again here in our church.
Amen. Good. God is working. God never stops working. Like the song said in the Bible, God never stops working. So that is good.
I thanks to God. God always take care of us, our family, our community, all persons, all the peoples. I hope always.
Today I don't put in Nepali the verses also because Baba is not here, so we all understand. So I keep singing English.
And I also understand.
So okay, it's my turn. So I thank God for this past week, and because I thank God because I have multiple things to thank. Actually, it's not just one thing. Actually, I thank God for a good health. I thank God for the protection. I thank God I survived till now. I thank God for everything. I rejoice because God make me something. It's not my ability, but it's the ability of the God who provide me the strength to stand firm. First week, Baba was here. The last week, Baba was here. My father was here. He was here. And from last 2 weeks, he was here, he was attending the US, and really, these things really work out in a very positive manner to him. This morning he called me, and he told me, please, give my J mercy and regards to each and everyone that comes to the Bible study. Okay. So he don't forget. So I thank God, he remembered. I thank God, he remembered. That what blessings we are here together. We are gathered here for the blessing, for praising. He remember the praising the God. In the same time, I thank God this past week, this week, because I go with my father in the village, and the half road is bus, and the half road is I have to walk. So I walk around 7 hours. I walk around 7 hours continuously going up in the hill area. And it was very sunny. I was very tired actually. I was very tired, and my hope, you know, and my hope and my strength both are going down. And there was a power. Let's say it is from the Holy Spirit actually. There was a power I felt who told me, rise and stand. God is with you. Because you are going now this time for the God, for the work of the God. Okay? Rejoice and you go. Then I walk, and every time I walk, my strength I get back. Every time I start, rise, my strength get back. Then I able to walk without sitting. So I walk, so I get in 7 hours, otherwise it will take 10 hours for me to walk like a person like me, with a bit very small belly.
For
so
Baba, time, for Baba 3 hours.
For Baba 3 to 4 hours, it's okay. For me, because I am a friend in that area, so that's the reason. So I go there in the village and I pray also, and we pray the last time also, and we pray from many days before for our village. There will be a gospel, there will be a Bible fellowship for the first time, spreading the words of the God. And I praise God the day I reached and the next day, I wasn't expecting that people will come that much, but I prayed and I go there. It was no person when I stand there. Then slowly, slowly the people started to come and I praise God. The first time 21 people were gathered to listen to the words of the God. I have a short clip of video which I will show also after this, our topic. So I brought the video of the village also so you can see all see. So thank you for the prayers, all works, and thank you to God to make this one possible. Okay? And my going and coming back and everything, it was all safe. Now in the village, you know, because in the village there is leeches, you know what is leech?
Yes.
The one, the blood sucking the insect, okay,
yes.
The leech. Okay. So when I go also, there was no leech with me. When I come back also, there was no leech with me.
Yes.
Even though I have been asked to come with me, a lot of leech with him in the road. But me, he was with shoes, but I was with slippers only. It was very easy for me, if, for the leech to bite me. But I was not with any single leech. Glory to God.
Oh my God.
Okay. So this is all possible because of the God. So I thank God for everything. I thank God for everything. Okay. So now, today we will talk something for uncertainty. Yeah. Now the things in this world are uncertain actually. Uncertain is the thing which are unplanned actually. Or we could not predict that one. Or it is out of control. It's uncertain. We never thought that it will happen, right? So let's talk about uncertainty. Now, today we will know about three different uncertainty. So the first one is navigating instability. Navigating stability. Stability, when the person is stability, he is stable, the person is actually is constant, he is stable. Some people say, oh, you are very stable in your life, oh, you are very stable in your business, oh, you are very stable in your house, your children are very stable. So everyone wanted to be stable actually nowadays. Right? Everyone wanted to do business, everyone wanted to do work, everyone wanted to build a good house, fast car, fast bike, everything. People wanted to be stable. But we will talk about something, navigating instability. Okay. The modern society gave us four pillars actually. The modern society gave us four pillars. The number one pillar is known as efficiency. Number two is predictability. Number three is calculability. Number four is control. So these are the four pillars provided by modern society to us, okay? And mostly people run according to these pillars actually. These are the pillars holding the peoples. So we will know now why. Let's see the efficiency, brother Arsene.
Efficiency. It's about planning and designing, trusting on the plan and design to be perfect, to get always better and better for us. Example, plan for the best education for our children, best vacations, best career, best job, best life, best retirement, best house, best cars. All things we want for us is best for best, best of best. People run as a modern society thought to run every day to get the best of best. People want to be sustainable, innovative, accurate, and precise on our own.
Okay, thank you. So, this is the world today, actually, the efficiency. The efficiency tells us, the modern society efficiency tells us that we really need something better, always better, okay? Like for example, before I get a job, okay, I get a good salary. After 2 months, I start searching another job because I wanted better opportunity. Okay, if I earn 50,000, I wanted something 70,000. It is never so because better I wanted. Okay, if people have 1 floor house, they wanted to make another floor up also because better. It looks better. If I have bike, I wanted a car actually because it's better. If I have a bicycle, I wanted a bike because it's better. Okay. So everything is better. We want it in our life is better. Better love is also required. Okay? People have a thing, no, this is so much gear. Better wife is required, better husband is required. Better retirement is required. Better child is required. So everything is better. Our efficiency is, you know, we work for, we run for better. who wanted better. So this is the efficiency taught by the modern society to us. Now, people wanted to be sustainable by their own plan. No, I wanted to plan myself because my plan will make me sustain. Okay, I will be constant. Nothing, no pandemic, no uncertainty, nothing. Nothing can shake because I have a best of best of mine. I wanted to be sustainable. I wanted to be innovative. I wanted to be very accurate, very precise on my own. So this is my own plan. Okay. Now what scripture is telling us is Proverbs 3:5-6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not. Okay. All your heart and lean not means depend not on your own understanding. Okay. Where the God, the scripture is telling, do not depend on your own understanding. For in all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. So, normally, people feel bored to do this one. Because they think, I am very efficient. Because I have best money. I have best friend. I have best love. If not in house, maybe in house outside. Everything is best. Everything is best, people think. Why I need to submit? Why? Right? Let's read Proverbs 28:26. Proverbs 28:26.
Those who trust in themselves are fools, but those who have walked in wisdom are kept safe.
Thank you. So, those who have a trust of best, I am best because I create best, because my plan was best, because my strength was best. So, those are considered in the eyes of God are fools actually. Okay? The best is the person who is really wise, and the wise person will do what? He will submit to the master. Okay? The God Lord. Because without Him, there is nothing best. With Him, everything is best. Okay? So submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. God is not telling that don't do. But we have to surrender our plan to God. That, okay, if He will, it is in His will, then this will be happening. If it is in His will, this will be done. So this is how the efficiency, modern society teach us this, and the scripture teach us this. Okay, this is what. Okay, next is predictability. Okay, Sanjeev.
The ability to predict is assume exactly how it works according to the plan you desire. Being pretty sure the plan works accordingly to the module, people expect and depend on the plan and design created by own ability, how resourceful it could be or how great it could be.
This is another modern society taught us. The first was efficiency, best of best. Second is the modern society said, things we can predictable. We can predict actually. Okay, we can predict. The modern society telling, trust on your plan. Okay, trust on your plan. If I invest 1 lakh today, tomorrow it will come in 2 lakhs. This is business. It is going up. I can predict. I can predict the market. I can predict tomorrow I will buy this land. I will make a big house. After 3 years, I will buy one boat and I will drive that boat in the Fewa Lake. Okay, people predict. People make so much prediction. People make the prediction very far. Okay, so here it says, we are here, modern society say, predict. We plan first. Efficiency say we plan. Then what we do? We started designing. We started after 2 years, after 3 years, after 5 years, after 10 years, we design. Then we predict what? How resourceful, how great actually my plan, how good, how big I am, right? I'm very great because I predict very right. I predict very precisely. I predict very accurately. So now let's see what is the scripture is telling us about the prediction. Now, James 4:13-16, Sister Ruchi.
Now listen, you who sing, today or tomorrow we will go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on business and make money. Why? You do not even know what will happen tomorrow. What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or that. As it is, you boast in your arrogant skills. All such boasting is error.
Thanks. It's very clear, right? It's very clear. Because this is what the modern society tell us. Okay? What happened? You don't have money because you don't have good plan. You don't predict. You are not wise. You are not wise like me. The modern society teaches us to how to see the people's down, how to see the people. No, you don't have a good bike. I have. You don't have a bike. Good bike. I have. You don't have a good house. I have. Okay. And I have so many things I can do more in future. 5 years, next 5 years, I will be a billionaire. I have so much investment in the market, so much super money I have. If I die, who will need that? So here it is telling, the life of human is like actually a mist. You know what is the mist? La fog, we see the fog. Okay. So mist is similar like fog. The droplets, the cloud droplets will come down. Okay. So it is here, after the sun shines very hard, mist is vanished, it's gone. So our life is this one. People stand, immediately attack him and they fell down. People go outside, something happened, they are no more. Okay. Then people go, they are like, maybe the people don't have leg, people don't have hand. Something happens, people, because we cannot predict. We are like a mist. We will never know when we will vanish. So, every time we tell anything else, instead of boasting how resourceful and how great we are, we have to tell if it is the God's will. We have to keep Him as our first priority. We are telling that if it is God's will, we will live, do this or do that. If it is God's will, not my will, if it is God's will. Okay? So, let's see John chapter 13:7.
Jesus answered and said unto him, what I do thou knowest not now, but thou shalt know hereafter.
Which verse is this? NIV?
KJV.
KJV?
KJV.
We have NIV?
Jesus replied, you do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand.
Okay. Okay, so what happens? God is telling here, okay, sometimes we cannot predict, right? We cannot predict left and right. Like for example, coronavirus. Okay, some people run, news came, tomorrow no more market. Yeah. 2 months stuck, 3 months stuck, run. No more vegetable, yeah. Run. No more medicine, yeah. Run. Because we wanted to save. Okay? There's nothing bad to be safe. Okay? And we predict after next month this will happen. After that month this will happen. After that I have this much stock. I have this one, this one. We have this one, this one. Then what we do? We forget what God is telling. Okay? God is telling what He is planning. Okay. We don't understand actually now. But later we can understand. Now I'll tell you. I was working in Bahrain before. Okay? That time I was working in Bahrain, sister and brother knows, okay? I worked only 3 months there. I'll tell you the story. It's a big hotel, four-star hotel, and I am the operation manager in that hotel, okay? Although the hotel have 5 discos outlets, okay? And I was working there. Then what happened? One day, I have to come in the night also to check the audit, the money and these all things. There are so much bodybuilders in this hall of the hotels, the bouncers. Then I have to come and go check every outlet if the money is okay, everything is good. So one day what happened in the evening, I could not sleep. My stomach really pain so hard. So I feel very hard. Then I tell him to God, my stomach is paining. How I will do work? heal my stomach, but it's not healing actually. It's more paining. It's more and more paining. So I called to the bus, the owner. I said, sir, my stomach, I don't know. It's become very uncertain. I don't know. Now I have to go back to the room. If I'm okay, I will come back. So I go, instead of going 1 o'clock, 12 o'clock, I go that time, 9 o'clock in the night. I go to my flat, okay? And in the morning, when I come back, the hotel was sealed. Because that night, when I go, the night 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, the police came and there was some illegal business was going on in the hotel. They arrest the hotel people. They arrest the F&B manager, they arrest the other manager, even housekeeping manager was arrested and they are gone in the jail. Okay. But I was saved because of my stomach. Now, if I know the God's plan, then I should keep quiet. But as I don't know what I said, God, my stomach is paining, come on, heal me. Heal me, but I'm not healing. So this is what the God is telling. God is telling, you don't know what is my plan. You will understand it later. The only thing you have to or I have to know is to that God's will. Trust. Rejoice whatever the situation it is. Trust in the God's will. Okay?
Lord, my Krishna resented you.
Okay.
I was fighting to him because he resigned in Oyo.
Okay, Christine.
Calculability. Now we prepare algorithms to work perfectly according to our plan and predictability. We make diagrams and charts to present that the plan is reliable. We start building it, bringing the plan in reality. People want to change the things, promoting the idea of the element that this is best and we can fully depend on it.
Okay, thank you. So now we prepare diagrams actually, flowcharts, okay? We make it. We plan it. We plan before, only from our mind. Okay. Then after the plan, we predict how good and great it will be. Now we are making it in real. How it looks. Okay. Calculability. Okay. So we think our plan and predict section. Predict. What is we predict? Okay. We make diagram and chart to present the plan is reliable. Reliable means very trustable. We can depend very easily. Our plan is good because it's great. We predict already it is having a boom in the market, it's profit. So it's reliable. We can depend on that plan. Okay. So we start building it, bringing the plan in reality. Okay. In reality, we will start bringing it. Investing, making, okay. We will make because we predict it is a very profitable thing. So people want to change the things, promoting their idea of the element that this is best and we can fully depend on it. Okay. There are a lot of people. Let's take a very simple example. Advertisement, right? Head and Shoulders. If you use this one, no dandruff. Pantene, if you use this one, no dandruff. Okay? Samsung, 12 megapixel. Samsung, 1000 more, 14 megapixel. 2000 more, 18 megapixel. Nokia didn't work, but 14 megapixel. So many things. Okay? Depend. They wanted, you know, calculability. This one depend. It needs to be depend on that one, okay? Before, what happens? Everyone cook. Now, people buy the things, okay? Microwavable things, sometimes they buy. They put in the microwave. They watch TV. Ding! Depend. Technology, depend. Everything depends. So people wanted to make the best of best. They plan, they predict, and they make it reality. Okay? As per them, it is easy. When we can depend, reliable. Okay? Now let's see what the scripture is telling. In Judges 7:2.
The Lord said to Gideon, you have too many warriors with you. If I let all of you fight the Midianites, the Israelites will boast to me that they saved themselves by their own strength.
Thank you, sister. Okay. Now here. Okay, there is going to be a war, okay, between the Gideons and Midianites. Okay. Now, These peoples are the Israeli peoples. There is going to be a war. There is going to be a fight between the Moses and Israel. Now, God is telling, I will help because Israeli are the people of God. God wants to help. But the thing is what, no? People nature. When God help and we have enough, what do we do? I was good because it was my ability. Because I was educated actually, you know. Because I have money, you know. Because I have contacts, you know. Because the market know me. Because I have lot of people. My network is very big. So all because of me, not because of God. So this is why the God is telling, okay, the Israeli, I let all of you fight in the next. The Israeli will boast to me that they have saved themselves. So sometimes, you know, it is important for us to go in the list. So when we will go in the list, we will experience more the blessings of the God. Okay?
Be humble.
Be humble, yes. When we will go in the list, for example, before Corona, before this pandemic, okay, we go restaurant, 1500, eat, 2000, eat,
yeah.
3000, eat, throw, eat, enjoy, go back, what any? What? Money have, job have, business have, okay? Now what happened? Pandemic come, okay? In the home, mungo rice, taste good? Very nice. If someone came there and bring, this is French fries. Thank you so much. So you know, we will realize that time how blessed we are before. But we don't realize that time actually. Because you know, we think, because I have job, I have business, I have network, I have this, I have blah, 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 because I am very powerful and this is a good person. I'm really great. Okay? So that's the reason sometimes these things happen in list. It goes, it makes us down list. So that what happened? We will be blessed highly. And when we will be blessed highly, we will acknowledge it. Not to us this time, to the God. God, I acknowledge. Yes. You are there. God, I acknowledge. Yes. Today I'm getting this meal. God, I don't have job. God, you are there. God, I acknowledge. My health is not good. I cannot go to hospital, but you help me. I acknowledge God. You are there. Okay? There are a lot of ways to acknowledge. So God is telling here, the Israeli will boast to me that they save themselves by their own strength. So to make a story, start of this session, okay? So God allowed or chose 300 people only to fight against a large army. And God proved that He is capable of everything because He is control of everything. And with that 300 people, a mass of Midianites army was lost with 300 people. And the people know God is great. He has control of everything else. Okay? So from the list, if they have so much in the number, they don't feel it. Even the God will help, but they will not feel it. So that is what in our category also. What we do is now we have to feel every small thing. We have to acknowledge the God. This is the opportunity God is giving to us to feel, to acknowledge Him that He is here with us and for us. Right? Okay. The last part of our society is called control. So, Sister Ruby.
The great source of uncertainty and unpredictability is unrationalizing system are people, either the people who work within those systems or the people who are served by them. People depend on the plan, prediction, presenting it practical and feel to have control of everything because we rely on the man-made source according to the modern society model.
Okay, thank you. Now, this is the great source of uncertainty. Really great source of uncertainty, okay? Now, here it is the system, okay? Government say, people, either the people who work with the system or the people who are served by system. Government say, Nepal having coronavirus, our contact is very good, we bring the medicine, you will be all healed in 1 week. All people come out on the road. Government control. We are in control. Our government, good, powerful. Everything is in control. Yes. Right? I have a problem. I go somewhere else. He give me a suggestion. Don't worry if you do this one like this, I will give you all power. We trust in the people. We forget the God. That is okay. So here what happened? We feel to be controlled. Okay? Sometimes we feel to be controlled to get controlled. Like country, like the powerful people of the country, the politicians, they tell so many things and they get control on us. Right? People get control on us. Products get control on us, like what I say, shampoo and this one and this one. All things, what they are doing, controlling us. Everything. Everything is controlling us, right? So, here, we think human being is, we depend on our plan, prediction, and presenting in practical, and feel we are in control. Everything we do is our hand, right? Like I said, before, when we go to market in the abroad, you know, before, there was no barcode scanner. There was a checker always there. After the things is filled in the software, if she will throw or he will throw, the person who is in the counter, and there's a checker was with the bill. Okay, next, okay. But now what happened? Scanner. Job gone of that person, right? We don't need that person. Okay. Before maintenance people, very black, they open, they wanted to see which one is not working, they will open everything and test. But now, automatic machine. What is this is the one, this is the one. Okay, change only this one. Okay, reducing the things. We are getting more and more control. And we desire to get more control, okay? So this is how we are very much relying, much depending on the man-made things of according to the modern society model. Okay? Now the scripture say, sister.
My thoughts are nothing like your thoughts, say the Lord, and my ways are far beyond anything you could imagine. For just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so many ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts.
So the God is telling, nothing like your thoughts. Our thoughts, our plans, our prediction, our power, our control, nothing like that. God is real. God is not a human being, right? So God is telling, nothing like your thoughts, okay? Says the Lord, and my ways are far beyond anything you could imagine. We cannot imagine the way of the God, because our mind is not that capable that we will compare with the Lord Father who created the whole world. So we cannot imagine also the capacity, the mind capacity of the Lord. For just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways. So you see the gap, the earth and heaven. And my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. So that's the reason the God is in all control. It's not us. But people here make mistake here that we are in all control. And we wanted to gain control of this one. Okay? So let's read James chapter 2, 18 and 19. James chapter 2, 18 and 19.
You believe that there is one God. God, even the demons believe that. And shudder.
18 and 19. 19
also. 18 and 19. But, okay, 18. But someone will say, you have faith, I have deeds. Show me your faith without deeds, and I will show you my faith by my deeds. You believe that there is one God, good, even the demons believe that.
Now why I put these verses is, you know, it doesn't mean that what I saw the modern society, I don't want you to get a wrong understanding that we will sit in the home and we will plan God. As today Bible study is given, you are already in control. I will lay down in the bed, God. Food should be in my door. It should bell. I will open. Breakfast should come. I want slightly omelette and some lard. Okay? Because I have slightly like this, like I need fruit lard. I don't like so much rice because I am gaining weight. So this doesn't work actually. Okay? The God said in James chapter 2, 18 and 19 here, God said, we have to do the action. When it is not action, okay, what happened? when we are not doing the things in the action, we have failed. But without action is dead actually. So the demons, they believe they have failed. There is one God only. And they are second with the God. Demons, they know there is one God only, and they are second with the God also. So we believe also there is one God. So there is no difference belief. The thing is different is our action, our deeds. So that is the reason, yes, this all things we used to do, but we have to put now in the God on the top priority. Not in these things. Not planning ourselves, not predicting ourselves, okay? And not calculating ourselves, and not having control to ourselves, but do all to the Lord. Okay, let's read Proverbs 16:3. So you will understand. Proverbs 16:3.
It says, commit to the Lord whatever you do, and He will establish your plans.
Thank you. So, we have to do in the action. We cannot just sit or sleep and expect that God will give everything. We have to do in action. But the thing is that we have to commit everything to the God and trust God is the one who will fulfill that plan. Okay. Clear? Okay. So there are some events that I wanted to show also, okay? Starting with January, this year was full of uncertainty, okay? Starting from January, Hong Kong protest, okay? Protest against the China is a political instability. Floods in Indonesia, capital Jakarta, nearby the town, killed 66 people and forced 400,000 people to flee their homes, at least 182 neighbors, okay? Bryant, Kobe Bryant, we all know. The 5-time NBA championship basketball with his daughter died in a helicopter crash. 9 people, including the crew, they died also. In January, COVID-19 pandemic was declared as a pandemic, as an outbreak of the disease, as public health emergency of international concern. Okay, in January. The locust started in Africa, Arabian Peninsula, Peninsula, South Asia, South America, even in the Ethiopia, Somalia, India, including the Nepal also. We have locust this time. The outbreak is worse in 70 years. It was very worse, okay, in Kenya. And worse in 25 in Ethiopia, Somalia, India, and even in Nepal. Okay. Now, we are very aware of this news. This is very latest, the Beirut. Okay, it was blasted, okay. 6,000 people injured, 157 people killed, and $5 billion is damaged. Okay. Now a Pakistan International Airlines crashed into houses in Karachi on May 2, killing 97 people. Similarly with this news, an Indian Express flight from Dubai with 190 people, it also get crushed, killing 18 people, including the pilots. Okay. Now the question is this one. Where is the plan and designs to deal with it? We should, if we are able to do everything, then this should not be happening. We should have a plan and design before this one. Okay? Why are it predicted? Why we didn't predict that Corona will come? We have to do this thing. We have to make a medicine because SARS was came already. SARS 1. This is SARS 2. So we have to make a medicine. Why people don't predict? Okay? Where is the great power and strength? US, I'm powerful. UK, I'm powerful. China, I'm very powerful. South Korea, I'm powerful. This one powerful, that one powerful. All people, oh, I wanted to go US. Oh, I wanted to go China. I wanted to this one have missile, this one have atomic bomb, this one have nuclear, this one have radiation. So many things have here and left and right, okay? Where is the power now? Why in Europe so many people are dying? They don't have money, they have money. What more than us? Then our country or Philippines or Nepal or India, they have much more money. Why? Because they don't have control. US, the number one people are dying and infected. Where is the power? Where are the resources? Where is the plan? Where is the design? Where is the flowcharts? How? Are humans in control of everything?
No.
So, uncertainty comes because you know, these four things is provided us from the modern society. And these four things, we do plan ourselves, we predict ourselves, we calculate ourselves, and we rely, we are very strong. Okay? Like for example, in village, I was coming, there is one village, it's called Burung village, it's called Gate. Welcome in Vikas Somi. One people have a house, all houses were okay, and one person have a house, only team. The wall is also a team. Okay? The meta, the team, half is also a team, a small. Then I tell to Vikas, Vikas, what happened? This all houses are okay, this person is poor maybe, or it's like this. He said, no. He have very good houses. No, actually, good houses before. Okay? He have family members, he have children, he have very good house. Okay? Unexpectedly, uncertainly, before 3 years, 4 years before, a landslide came with his wife and two children dead in the landslide and the house is gone. Now he don't have money, he make it this way. Uncertainty, right? Okay? So we are like mist, like fog. So there is no reason to make the nose like a very big, like a horse. I have something, I'm in control, I'm like this, I'm like this. So there is no need. Because we don't know what is tomorrow is waiting for us. Okay. Afghanistan, Iraq, Iran. You see, uncertainties. China, uncertainties. Right? So that is the reason. The fact is no one knows. It was all unexpected. Right? It was all unexpected. And no control of humans. We don't have control, right? If we have control, we don't want it to stay inside, right? Every time, if we have control. Right? We wanted to go for our work, we wanted to look for work, we wanted to look for opportunity. But what is making us stay? Stay, eat whatever you found, just survive. Why? Because we are not in control. The truth is this one. We have to accept it. Okay? We need an anchor, right? Outside of the storm. When the ship, big ship, there is a storm and this one, there is the water, whirlpool or something else, what the ship do? They throw the anchor outside of the storm. The anchor will hold the ground. The ship will slowly go to there. Okay? We need the anchor. We need to attach outside of the world. Okay? Outside of the world means outside of the thinking of modern society. Not actually going Mars, Jupiter, Venus, not that much smart. Okay? Outside of the world means it's the outside of the thinking out from the box, thinking out from the modern society. So the truth, Jesus Christ provides anchored navigate outside of the storm. No name in the heaven and earth is given except the Jesus Christ. To provide the anchor navigating outside of the storm. Okay. Clear?
Outside of the storm is like a problem or something?
No. Outside of the storm means we are no more of ourselves, but we are of Christ. Okay? We feel afraid, you know why? We feel this one because we feel, oh, maybe we'll die. Maybe tomorrow no food. Maybe tomorrow is like this. Maybe day after tomorrow is like this. Maybe because we predict so many things. God said, if you worry, it will not add you a hour or a minute or a day or anything in your life, right? If we worry, the God said. Okay. So if we wanted to live a life relying, depending on something which is really higher, which is really right, it is only the Jesus Christ. So we can be outside of the storm. Okay. It will be not disturbing. Okay, it will be not disturbing. For example, to me, I don't have work. Comes sometimes in the mind, oh, I don't have work, rent need to give, my money is very less, what I will do and this one. Then immediately my insights speak up and we pray and all. Okay. There is someone, let him do his work. What can we do? Oh, it's not in my control. Come on. It's not in my control. What can I do? It's control. Because this is the name is provided to the heaven and the earth that he can only navigate outside of the storm. So I give only Jesus Christ. Okay. Number two. Number one was navigating instability. Number two, rethinking independence. Brother Arsene.
Rethinking independence. People talk about financial independence and emotional independence, but the fact is all systematical independence is false. Whoever says they are independent, they are fundamentally dependent on the idea of dependence. Do all people submit to something but what we depend on? People depend on other things. Depend on Jesus Christ only. His historical documents shows evidence that we need to depend on Him.
Okay, thank you. Okay, people talk about financial independence, right? People talk about financial independence. No, it's okay, I have bank, so much bulk money I have in the bank, interest is coming. Okay, investment, I have so much share market investment. There was my one friend, Aswan, I used to call Aswan, he always showed me he had a very good investment in the share market. Okay, so I remember, people depend. Okay, people depend on emotional independence. Okay, they think, no, it's okay. It's all about business, it's not about the relationship. It's all about the business. I'm emotionally free. Okay, if I am, like for example, I am not attached in something. If I need to something, then I have other opportunity, other alternative to get it. Okay, I can buy love, I can buy food, I can buy people, I can buy everything. So I'm free of emotionally, I'm not attached. There's just so many things. Robot is came. Nowadays, robot wife is also available, right? We know there's a robot wife is available. Robot husband is available. Full satisfaction.
In Japan.
So people wanted to do, you know? People wanted to reach thinking the independence. Whether financial, whether emotional. But the fact is, all is systematic. Independence is false. Okay. Whoever says they are independent, they are fundamentally dependent on the idea of independence. For example, I am financially independent, if I say. But I am not. Actually, I am dependent on the fundamental idea. What fundamental idea? In the bank, I put my money in a yearly 9% interest, right? I depend on the interest, the idea of the bank. I am not independent. But I am dependent on the bank. Tomorrow, there will be war, there will be collapse bank, the money will come back. Afghanistan people, so many people, Iraq, so many people, the money come back, no? Gone. So much rich people's gone. Okay. That is why he said, depend. For example, it's not just Christian, different people also. If I will tell the other people also, in other religion, they depend also. They say, oh, I have money, I have this one, I have that one. Then they say, oh, Ram, Siam, Sita, Mata, Gita, please, help me. They pray also in that. Some say different names, some say different names. They are, but they depend on the fundamental dependence. There is a superstitious belief, you know. When I was in India, there is a village, if you go, there are Baba. Baba means, they are like in Hindu, they are saints with Aghori Baba and this whole thing, they are Baba. And Aghori Baba is something who is, you know, after the leftover, the bun of human meat, they used to eat Aghori Baba. And those Baba are known as very famous in India, okay? And people depend on their ideas so much. My son, you do this one, you will be released. Whatever comes to his mind, he will tell. And he will depend on this one. So actually, people who think they are not depending, they are independent. Actually, they are depending always in the fundamental level of the idea of independence. Whatever it is, they are dependent. So, do all people submit to something? Every people submit to something. What will depend? So, people depend on other things. Whether it is their guts, whether it is their bank account, whether it is their robot husband or wife, whether it is girlfriend, boyfriend, whether they depend on the system. Okay? They depend on the system made by the government. They depend on the system made by the people. They depend on everything. The bank, money, share. They depend on the market. Right? Everything they depend. But still they say, we are independent. Okay? So, the truth is, depend on Jesus Christ. Only his historical documents show the evidence that we need to depend on him. Okay? In Psalms 62:5-8. Stephen.
Depend on God alone. I put my hope in him. He alone protects and saves me. He is my defender, and I shall never be defeated. My salvation and honor depend on God. He is my strong protector. He is my shelter. Trust in God at all times, my people. Tell him all your troubles.
depend on God. No? There is nothing. There is no one we can depend except Jesus Christ, except the God. Okay, alone. I put my hope in Him. He alone protects and saves me. He alone protects and saves me. Right? Till now, who protect us? It is our power. If I will tell honestly, coronavirus. WHO said coronavirus is airborne, right? Airborne. Okay. If airborne, we are not every time in the mask in home, right? I know. If we are going exposing outside, then it is much more risk. I'm not telling it's not spreading, it's risk. But staying in the house is also, we are not risk free, right? Airborne. Maybe in the side of someone, who knows? Airborne, right? It's airborne from the air. And people said coronavirus can be transferred by human tissues. So the carrier of human tissues is what? Housefly. Right? They carry human tissues. Okay? They go in your hand something, you eat something, the person have a corona, they sit and they come and they put. Can I eat? Right? You can avoid such situation, no. But you can do one thing. You can trust Him. He alone protects and saves me. He is my defender. Okay? Who sustains me, who fights for me? He is my defender. And I shall never be defeated. Okay? There are many people who have coronavirus, who are coronavirus before, but they have defended successfully through the time. There is much more testimony. If you see in YouTube, there are so many people. Okay? So we have to trust in the God because He is our protector, our shelter, our refuge in the time of all troubles. Okay? That is the reason. People forget these things normally when they are okay. They think about their control. But when the situation comes, the trouble comes, what happens? People come back to the God. So this is the opportunity also. This is the opportunity of uncertainty that people change to the situation, to the modern society. Now they go to the back, the reality, the back that they are going back to the God. Like for me, this coronavirus, okay, I don't have job, yes, that is bad, but this coronavirus give me this opportunity to spend a much more time with the God, right? Before I don't have that opportunity. This time, this 5 to 6 months, was a wonderful time for me. I rejoice with the God because I get the opportunity to connect with the God's word. So now, deal with suffering. Okay? So suffering comes to everyone. No matter what we believe or what we are, different people have different thinking of suffering. Example, okay? You need to suffer because of past life. There are people who will tell, "Oh, my house is never peaceful. It's like this." You know what? Your past life was not good. Your past life was bad. You did something bad in your past, but now you carry forward your sin. Okay? Mostly this one happens in the people's Hindu people's the past life. Okay? You have so much desire. That's the reason. Family members, no, you know your grandfather did this sin, now this one, like this, it comes to you now. Now you are also like that. Okay? It's your fault, every time it's your fault. Okay? So there are different people who will talk different things. Okay? But the truth is, Jesus understands us, and He loves us so much. So Jesus took all the suffering and the And He conquers including the death. Because He rises again from the He rose again from the death. So we understand. Jesus paid in bulk our past, present, and future. Okay? But that doesn't mean that we need to be every time sin because it's forgiveness. Okay? But Jesus paid, normally Jesus paid to His father. Now, let's see the scriptures. So in Isaiah 53:4-6, whom I will tell, brothers and sisters.
Yet it was our weaknesses He carried. It was our sorrow that weighed Him down. And
He said,
His trouble were a punishment from God. A punishment for His own sins. But He was pierced for our rebellion. Crosses for our sins, He was beaten so we could be whole. He was wait so we could be healed. All of us, like sheep, have strayed away. We have left God's path to follow our own. Yet the Lord laid on him the sins of us all.
Okay. So it was our weakness he carried actually. It was our sins, it is our weakness, okay? It is our suffering, our sorrows, everything he carried. Okay? He was pierced, because of our rebellion, he was crushed. He was pressed hard, he was crushed for our sin. He was beaten, could be whole, so that he could be whole. He was whipped. Whipped is the, in Nepal, hunter, hunter. Okay, so the one which is made by the leather, sometimes having the what the small thorns also, okay, used to hit the animal. Okay, so he was whipped so he could be healed actually. Okay, so all of us was like, you know, like a sheep, and stayed away, aimlessly move on, go this way, some go right, some go left, aimlessly. Okay, we are those sheep, but. What he did, yet the Lord Father, laid on him the sins of all of us. Okay. So, when suffering the dealing, we should understand Jesus understands us and he has done it. Okay. Okay, let's see Revelation chapter 21:4. This is the promise of the God. Okay, he will wipe all the tears, okay, all the pain and all the sufferings. Okay, and for everything, God put him laid down for our sins. Okay, now after that, all control and the modern society will come to the real topic. Okay, stamping pandemic COVID-19. Now the pandemic version. Okay, sometimes it is difficult to grasp the truth that God is in control and he continues to allow the COVID-19 pandemic to affect all of us. In fact, the world has battled numerous plagues in the past. So, we see, this is some of the examples. I cannot put so many all. There are number of more than this. I just took some only. Okay. So, in this 249 to 262 AD, the Cyprian plague, 5,000 people every day die in Rome that time. 5,000 people died every day in Rome. Now, next, 541 to 542 AD, okay, the Justinian plague, where half of the world population, 30 to 50 million people dead. 13th century, 25 million. Spanish flu, 500 million. So, we understand what? It is just to show that the today's pandemic COVID-19 is not new, right? It's not new. People think it is very new, maybe like before in that time. No, it's not new. Before, many horrible things happened. This COVID-19 actually, if we see the death rate, okay, of COVID-19, if you compare with this one, it's still less, very less. Okay. So, now, amazingly, it was during the plagues when Christians become more distinct from others as they care for, minister to and drew more people to the Lord during the time of Rome, when the 5,000 people died, and drew more people to the Lord. God is always involved in these catastrophic events. He is trying to wake up the world and remind believers he is God. Okay, why? The answer is this one. Okay, because he is trying to wake up the world and the believers, telling, see, I am the God. I created you. You have to plan according to my will. I created you to praise me. I created you to glorify my name. I created you so that you and me, the Father and Son, united in the heaven. So he created. So that's the reason. He's trying to wake up the world and remind believers that he is God. No amount of money or power can solve the crisis apart from the divine intervention. There are thousands, millions and billions of people are praying now to the God. The people who don't want to go to church, you can see the videos now. People, they put their knee down on the road to praise God now. Why? Because God reminds us to the believers also that He is God. We should be only follow to His way, not our plan, not our control, not our power, not resourceful. It's all about God. So, now, many of us are learning to grow closer to the Lord. I'll use this time to examine our life and propose for living. This is me. I'm here also. I'm not outside. In this last line, I'm here. Okay? God is using this time actually to grow more closer to the God. I was never this closer to the God before. But God is creating now more closer to examine our life and purpose of living. Okay? So this is the picture during the time. Someone painted. Okay. In Philippians 4:1-7. Therefore, my dear brother and sister, this is Paul is telling now here. Okay, this is the words of Paul. He's in the prison. Now he is telling through his letter, the writing. Now Paul is telling. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, stay true to the God. Stay true means stand firm. Okay? Stand firm. The stand firm is came from the word Greek word is called steko. 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 The Greek word. Yeah. The Greek word steko. The steko means what, you know? The steko means don't give up. Stand firm. Don't give up. Okay? Steady first. Don't give up. Okay? So here is telling. Stay true, something that means to the Lord. I love you and long to see you, dear friends. You are my joy and the crown. Now, Paul is telling. Therefore, means there is a reason. In Philippians 3:21, it's mentioned the promise of resurrection. Okay. Now, Paul is telling. Therefore, he's pointing the Philippians 3:21. He said, therefore. My dear brother and sister, stand firm, because we have a more good reason. Okay, the reason is in Philippians 3:21. The reason, the promise of resurrection. So stay firm to the Lord now, because we have a good reason to stay firm. I love you and long to see you. Dear friends, for you are my joy and the crown. So this crown is not a king crown. This is the trophy he's talking about, his achievements. And these peoples are the one. The Philippians people, the church in Philippians, the people who stand strong are the achievement, are the trophies of Paul. So he's telling, these are the crowns. He loved them because they are stand firm. They are the crowns I receive for my work. Now, he's telling, now I appeal to Yodia and Sintechi. What is the Sintechi? Or Saintechi?
Sintechi.
Okay, please, because you belong to the Lord, settle your disagreement, okay? And I ask you, my true partner, to help these two women, for they work hard with me in telling others the good news. Now, what Paul is wanted to tell there, okay, there is two ladies of church, okay? And they are having an argument in the church. They have a great argument. They don't, they quarrel for something. They don't settle. So Paul is telling that, okay? Because you belong to the Lord, settle the disagreement. He's telling to the church to settle, means reconcile these two ladies. Okay? Reconcile in Lord. So reconcile in Lord. That means our part, being a human being, our part, our ground truth is much more higher than to quarrel each other. Because we are here to fulfill the purpose that God has provided us, than to quarrel to each other. So that is the reason he's telling, reconcile, okay? And now he's telling, these women are work hard, means they labor hard with Paul to spread the words of the God, okay? They work hard. And he's telling, okay, they work along with the Clement and the rest of my co-workers, okay? normally the climate, normal the people who are the priest of the temples, but I don't know if they are the same, because the climate is the normal word used for the priest also. It's a normal word in that time. And the rest of my co-workers, those names are written in the book of life. So, these people's names are actually written in the book of life already. So we have a higher purpose. We should not argue, but we should see each other. We should come to agreement. We should come to a reconciliation. So always be full of joy in the Lord, is telling. I say it again, rejoice. Despite of whatever situation, Paul is telling. Because he is thinking of different people. Where is he, you know? He is in prison actually. He is not present in the church. So that's the reason he is writing the letter to the church. So in fact, he is in the prison. So he is thinking about the people who are in the church. He is thinking people who are the, his trophies. He is thinking about the Philippians. Okay? And he is telling, rejoice. Let everyone see that you are considerate in all you do. Means you are carefully doing the things, okay? You are doing very carefully the things in all whatever you do. Do not hurt to the peoples, this word. Carefully doing and not hurting to the peoples, okay? In all you do. Remember, the Lord is coming soon. So Paul is hoping that the Lord will be coming soon, okay? Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need. Paul is telling here, and this is not the word of Paul. We see in the Bible, it's mentioned every word written in the Bible is not the people who they eat, drink, sleep, and they write. No, it's the Holy Spirit who come and tell them, hold the pen and write. What I'm telling you, write. And then they are the one who write it. The Holy Spirit is the one who's telling them, write this. So he's telling, what you need? Okay? Tell God what you need. And thank him for all he has done. Sometimes we forget because we believe in our power was enough. Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything we can understand. His peace will guard your hearts and minds, and you live in Jesus Christ. Okay? Okay? In Ephesians 6:10-11, finally be strong in the Lord and his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your part, stand against the devil's scheme. Now, this pandemic, there are two things. If we are the believers of the God, and you believe in the God, and we do in the fellowship is much more impact, you know. Even here, even we will do in Zoom or whatever, the fellowship is much more impact. If we are always connected, we talk about the God in this one, then our overview will what? In case of anything else up and down, we will go back to the God. Like we do now, we go back to the God. And God is very good, he accepts us. And we survive, we are safe because of the God. Okay? And there are the other peoples also, what they will do this time, who are not united in God, the devil will give schemes. The devil schemes. You don't have food, where is your God? See your child sick, where is your God? See this one, your father is very sick. Where is your God? Your mother is sick. Where is your God? You don't have rent. Where is your God? You don't have this. Where is your God? This is the schemes of the God. This is the schemes of the David. Okay? David is coming with his schemes. Okay? To bring our mind diverted from the God and think, God is not in control actually. Actually, God is not powerful. Okay? Now, we have to put the armor of the God so that we will be take stand against the devil's scheme. So how? Once Jesus said the story of the wise and foolish people, if we learn God's word, but we do not apply them, we fool like the foolish men. We learn God's word. We read Bible, and after that the God said, no, you shall not commit this one, this and this one. Okay, Bible is written. After evening I will commit that one. Bible is written, it's word only, it's written. So here, if I do that one, then I build a house in the sand. It's very easy. The sea, the shore, the water will come and the sand will go with this, okay? Now he's telling, the wise person is someone who will build his life on a solid foundation, which is the stone. Rain came, wind came, the things came, hurricane came, everything came. The stone is fixed. Stone is stone. stone is not moving, it's not broken, because the foundation is very strong. And the foundation of stone is God's word. Hearing and action on it. Okay? A foolish man hears, but does not obey. A foolish man. He have not been promised a strong free life. We have not been. So here also, God is not promising that we will be having a stress free life. Yeah. There will be. Because you know why? This is important, because that time we will look for the God. That time we will acknowledge God. If everything is good, we will lust the taste of good also, right? If every day you eat fried chicken, after 1 week you will say, no, give me talkali, vegetable, please, enough. So this is what God is. God knows also. He don't want you to give us every day fried chicken, because we know, God knows. Sometimes He make us least so that we will get mature in spirit. We will get more closer to Him. Not for Him, for us, because what He wanted us to stay with Him, united with Him in His home. That is our nationality. We are nationality of heaven. So, but it builds our lives on God's truth. We can live strong proof life. Okay? Not strong free life, strong proof life. Mr. Stone's foundation. Strong foundation. Okay. Then in Matthew 7:23-24 it said, then I will tell them plainly, I never knew you. Away from me, you evil doers. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and put them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. This is what Jesus said, the story of the wise and foolish man. So we are here. We wanted to build our house in rock or sand?
Rock.
Rock? Amen. Okay. Stand firm in the faith. As we face this pandemic storm, let us stand firm. For the danger of falling away from the faith is always there. Okay, for the danger of falling away from the faith is always there. A true follower of Christ will be able to endure until the end. A true follower of Christ can hold on. Hold on. Second. I'm holding. I'm not falling down. Okay? Because not because I'm strong. Because I praise God. God make me good, strong, that I can hold because of His strength in me. I'm holding. So here it is telling. Whoever stand up to the end, actually, okay? Falling away from the faith, okay? The pain. The true follower of Christ will be able to endure until the end, okay? This is so important, because many so-called Christians failed at this, so we can do. So, how will you fail, stand firm? Okay, Luta. I am going a bus, I'm sitting here, from here, I'm going to Bednas Lake. Everyone knows where is Bednas Lake, right? Okay? Sisters, Bednas Lake, okay? And before going Bednas Lake, I will be going Prithvi Chowk, I will be going Amar Singh, Buddha Chowk, Budi Bazar, Tal Chowk, Siswa, Moria, then Bednas, right? So what happens if that is the road starting, the earth started, my trial started from Birota or Lakeside to Bednas Lake, Feva Lake to Bednas Lake, then Bednas Lake is the target, my race will end, like Paul said, my race will end. So, while in the bus, if I am follower of the Christ, then I will able to endure until the Bednas Lake. There is a lake, there is water, there is everything. But if I am not, then I will go in the devil's skin. Bednas Lake is desert. Why you are going, my dear? See, Buddha Chowk, see, Amar Singh, how good city. You can buy water, you can have a smoke, you can have a very good life, this one, that one, okay. Skin, I come down. Then another person, no, I will not. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Then Buddha, he go to Budi Bazar, Chowk, he will say, no, maybe he was right, Amar Singh, I should go down now. He will go down. So here, God is telling, enter until the end. Okay? So are you reaching the Bignas? He is asking. So in this point, I give you example. So here, God is telling, are you reaching the end, what God wanted us to do? So how do we start firm? But the one who start firm to the end will be saved. Matthew 24:13. So now, regards for others. So how do we stand firm? We are talking now. How do we stand firm? So number one, regard for others. This is very... Okay. Who am I able to... this time, Anna. Why this one need to rise?
Regard for others. This is very
counter, what is that? Counterintuitive.
Counterintuitive.
In times of crisis, yet Paul taught others while he in reason. He encouraged Yudia and Sintichi to reconcile and ask the church to help them do so. While conflicts are inevitable, it tells us to consider the interests of others and do not be self-seeking. Take the initiative to seek reconciliation. The virus of self-centeredness is rampant. Self-pity, self-righteousness, self-centeredness. You can never stand firm. Think of other more and see how you can be of help. Fix relationships. This avoids anger and bitterness to develop. Do not distance yourself from peoples you disagree with. Keep in mind Jesus command to love one another.
This is very clear. This is the one we talked before. Paul is writing a letter to reconcile. Now, take the initiative of seeking reconciliation. The virus, now the real virus is self-centeredness. It's very rampant. Which is very crucial. It's very, it's very crucial. It's very dangerous. Okay, it's rampant. Self-pity. Okay? Sometimes what happens, I'm self-pity. I don't have anything. Sister Evelyn also not see me. Sister Ki also don't want to tell me anything. Sister Ruby also. I'm very, my life is like that. I'm very unhappy in my life. Brother Samuel also don't see anything. I go there, he don't give also. So that's right. Self-righteousness, okay? No, actually, Sister Evelyn, what he said, I know more actually from her. More from Sister Rose. I have more brain from Sister K actually, I know everything more than what brother has, Because I'm the best. Okay? This is another type of disease. Self-centeredness disease, okay? Virus, self-pity, self-righteousness. Self-centeredness. Okay? I wanted in the circle, in the middle, okay? I wanted in the circle. If anything else, if there is people, four people is talking, I will come in the middle. Oh, what you are doing? Oh, it's nice. What is this? This is like this. Oh, what you are doing, sister? No, so all people should look me. All people should talk about me. Okay, because I wanted to be center. Okay, like in the magazine front photo. So I wanted to be like that front picture always. So this is the virus actually. This virus is self-pity, self-righteousness and self-centeredness. If this virus attacked us, we can never withstand it. Okay? So we have to save ourselves from this virus. Very rampant, very crucial, very dangerous virus this time. Okay? Think of others more and how you can be of help. Fix relationship which avoids anger and bitterness to develop. Okay? Do not distance yourself from the people you disagree. Okay? So when sometimes what happens, if I tell something, maybe brother Archie tells something different. Okay? So if I am a person with this virus of self-centeredness, then I will not see the face of brother Archie. Okay? Because I have virus. Or if I have self-righteousness, I will not see also. Because I know more than him. I trust it already. Okay? So this is the one. Regard for others, so think about others. The scriptures say in Philippians 2:4, not looking to your own interest, but each of you to the interest of the others. Okay, and this is very good verse also. Sometimes these words help you to stop conflicts also, it helps to stop conflicts. Even in husband and wife, even in brothers, even in sisters, it helps in relatives also. Because when you understand the interest of other person, okay, if you understand the interest of other person, then what you will do is, you will think about that person, okay, and you will respect about that person, okay. Like for example, in my house, okay, sometimes I cook something else, okay, like egg, curry, and this all things you don't like. It's her interest, okay, it's her interest, because she is not habited to eat that food. If I will tell, eat, your caste will not go away, you have to eat. This is not poison. Eat. This is just an example. Okay. So we have an understanding. If we wanted to eat also, we do in a smile, without hurting. You want to eat this one? This is very tasty. You know, I put dhania, I put this one. Daily I will try. See, honey, you want to eat? Eat this one. See how I cook with milk, this one. I put coconut also. You don't like this, I put. So, like this. Keeping the self-interest, you know, keeping the self-respect of each other. Okay. Do all things that you can, to you get to live in peace with everyone. Your love for one another will prove to the world that you are my disciples, okay? If we don't know how to love to each other, then we cannot prove to the people that we are the disciples of the world. John, that you can die. Very fast to finish now. Don't worry, I will finish it. So rejoice. So that's the reason I'm speaking myself now. I'm not telling anyone to speak, so because it is now almost going to finish. So second is rejoice.
Okay. Sometimes when they cook, they said, why you cook like this? Okay, you don't want to eat, don't eat.
No, we have to go in this one. Not looking to your own interest, but looking to other interests.
If I will not do this one, okay,
I will be a person who is, you know, is very self-righteous. So this will, you know, this will damage.
Yeah.
Maybe the people will not tell in the mouth, but if the things is here, you know, if making a hole, later on that will go big, and this will make a cancer. It's very hard to heal. Okay, cancer not the disease, but cancer in the feeling. Okay, so it is very hard. Okay, so we have to love one another so that the world we can prove that you are my disciple. And before the spreading of the words of God in the village, my father spoke there, and he said that I don't teach him what to tell. I don't teach him what to tell. But while he talked about heart, he said that my Buhari is very nice, is very good. Every time morning I wake up and say, I don't tell her anything, but coffee and bread will come on the table. That much she is taking care. And Nepali boy is very hard to get with that this type of behavior. But she is a foreigner. She is a foreigner. How she loved me. How the
Ruby.
Way she do.
Ruby.
And after that, what he said, you know? He said, if anyone is my relative, it is actually who are in Christ. They are actually relative because they know how to love. This is not the one I tell him to tell, but he tell by himself. He said, anyone who are in Christ are my relative actually. Because these people know how to love actually, how to care without asking. Without asking or without thinking, getting back anything in return. But they just love. So this is what he tell before the spreading the words of the garden before. And many people say tell that. And this shows what her, in that way he thought, I remember that you are my disciples. He tell in front of the people that what is his feeling, and he appreciate Filipino Buhari than the Nepali Buhari. Okay, so John 13:35. Let's go. Number two is rejoice. We must keep on rejoicing in Lord always, not just in favorable circumstances. Joy is supernatural because it comes from the Holy Spirit. Okay, so what we need to do? We rejoice for him. We have money, we have good extra income. This one, hallelujah, God. Gut. After that gut, situation happens, I lose weight. No. Now, not watching. I will go, who have plan better, who have graph better, who have flowchart, who have control, I will go and try to find out. Okay. So he's telling that we have to rejoice always, we have to be thankful. Okay. Before we are thankful, or sometimes we forget to thankful, that we have a fried chicken. But now we have to thankful what we have a mungo and rice also. Because at least that is fulfilling our stomach, right? So you have to thankful in any conditions, in any circumstances. Joy is supernatural because it comes from the Holy Spirit. We can say that in times of COVID-19, we can still choose to rejoice in the fact God is real. Because God is real. We rejoice because God is real. And it's not a God of imagination, because He's a real God. Okay? Remember God's grace in His greatness for you. To be able to rejoice in the presence of challenges. This is not Daniel of our troubles. It is knowing that our joy is complete in Him. Okay? The joy of Lord is our strength. His assurance that He is with us. The hardest time is truly an unspoken word. joy. So the joy of the Lord is actually our strength, okay? Like I tell, I walk on the village, okay? I don't have so much sunlight and I cannot walk like this very hard. Putting one leg like this, putting another leg like this is going very high, right? So after that, the sun's sunlight, then I'm searching where the sand, I will burst it, I'm searching the stone like this, where I can sit. So every time I do like that, then I think in my mind is done. That God is my strength, Lord is my strength. And every time I remember, I pray. Every time I pray, it gives me hope, it gives me strength. Hope, strength, hope, strength. Then I reach there. And while reaching there, 2 hours. I get 2 hours in under the very heavy rainfall before I reach there. I was fully wet.
In 2 hours.
Okay. I was fully wet because my umbrella was taken from someone and he go very fast and my umbrella also. Okay, so he returned only in village after he goes there. So I was like this only. And in the mountain, here mountain, there mountain, the middle of the road, okay, where the juka is like this, okay, the leaves, and the rain is falling very hard, okay, and the stone is also falling like landslide can be any time, okay. God was there. My joy was God. And we pray for our safety while walking as Baba and me. And God really delivered us very safely in the home without one bite of fish. Imagine. Okay. If Ephesians 4:4, always be full of joy in the Lord. I see it again, rejoice. Again, that Paul is telling. Always be full of joy of Lord. Okay? Now, when you have joy of Lord, the God is number one priority. Your joy is in Lord. Then what will happen? Everything comes second priority, right? Your family, then your job, your friends, everything comes in second priority. Your first priority is the joy in the Lord. So when you have joy in the Lord, what you do? You don't expect. Like last time I said, you hope. Because your joy comes in the Lord. When someone come to you and say, then what happened? You think, my joy is not this person. This person is like this, then I have to try to reconcile, I have to try to settle the thing. But I will not feel bad when I remember my joy is God, not this person. Okay. And the believers were filled with joy with the Holy Spirit in Acts 13, 52. So, Habakkuk 3, 17, 18. Whatever happens, I will continue to thank the Lord. He's telling. So this is a very encouraging. Is that if there are no flowers on the fig tree? You know what is fig tree? Is it? Fig tree. Nevaro, Nevaro.
Sweet cookie.
Nevaro. How's Nevaro?
Fig, the one that is coming.
Akku just on said, doctor, you go in the damn side part, you hold. Like this you are sewing, that is fig tree.
Ratu.
Can be jam also, I was telling the fig tree. Nevaro. Nevaro, Nevaro. So fig tree. So he's telling, no flowers on the fig tree means there will be no fruit also. If there are no grapes on the vines, if there are no olives on the olive tree, if there are no crops in the fields, if the sheep are dying in the hills, if there are no cows on the farms, I will sing to thank the Lord. I will be happy because God is the one who makes me safe. Amen? In modest way, if I will tell, even there is no food, enough food, even there is rice only, or salt and rice, okay? Even there is no VIP food, even there is nothing like that, okay? Even I don't have so much facility, okay? Even I don't have so much money, only minimum little money. Even I don't have meat, even I don't have a milk or anything else like that. But still, whatever the condition despite it, even I have food, even I'm crying, even I'm happy, even I have tears, even I have whatever sorrows, but I still sing to thank God. I still praise God. Okay? And I will be happy because God is the one who makes me safe. Okay? Why I have to think much? He's the one who makes me right. I'm not in permanent in this world, right? If I'm permanent, then I have to think really. I'm not permanent. I'm like a mist tomorrow, now, or anytime. Nothing is permanent. Nothing is building is permanent. Nothing is permanent. Then why? I just praise God, yes. Because He's the one who is my tower and who is my refuge, who will keep me safe. Now, Nehemiah 8:10, Nehemiah said, go and enjoy the good food and sweet drinks. Give some food and drinks to those who don't prepare any food. Today is a special day to our Lord. Don't be sad because the joy of the Lord will make you strong. Okay? So, this is the time, okay, when Jerusalem was rebuilt. When Jerusalem was rebuilt in the time of Ezra and Nehemiah, okay? Then, after the rebuild, in Daniel chapter 9:24, as we see, 7 times 7 if you require to rebuild. So when it was rebuilt, okay, the people who were exiled 70 years in Babylon, they are returning back to their homeland, Jerusalem. Okay. So that time what happened? The priest Ezra was the priest, Ezra, and he opened the law of the God and he tried to tell the people what to do. So he preached. And the people, this is the law, this is the law of the God and this one. So people mourn, people cry because they have done multiple sins in their life. They don't know what they praise to other God, what they pray to other God is for all waste of the things. So now, to bring them hope, Nehemiah said this, that go and enjoy the food and give those people who don't have. At the same time, he said, today is a special day because today is the day they found Lord, the true Lord. So he said, today is the special day. So he said, don't be sad because we have God, we have Lord. He said, don't be sad because the joy of the Lord will make you strong. What makes us strong? Joy, right? If we think, Corona will attack me tomorrow, what I will do if I will die? Come on, if I will cough, achoo, and maybe Corona will. Today I have fever. I have corona already. Everything. Maybe I will die. What will happen to my family? Maybe what will have this one? So many things. So here he said, the joy of the Lord is the one actually make you strong. Because you depend. Or maybe I have like this. No. God is with me. Whatever it happens, it will be will of the God, not my will. So the joy of the Lord will make you strong. Nehemiah 10. Last. Rest in the world. Now, how do we rest in the world? With gentleness, without worry or anxiety, be thankful. With gentleness, gentle is sometimes translated as forbearance, meekness, or moderation. It is the Greek word epix, and it can mean being careful, handling conflict in a respectful manner, being forbearing, forgiving, and gracious, etc. Gentleness and submissiveness. Submissiveness. Thank you. So that Christ rules our heart. When people look at us, do they see us gentle and Christ-like, or they do see our irritation and complaining attitude?
Complaining.
My tongue is now not working. Complaining. So what people actually see us as a Christ-like or irritating or complaining? So sometimes we have to remember this because people are watching, far near people are watching, and they observe us actually. Okay? Like we observe our children's right, what they are doing, writing or not writing. The children observe the mother and father in a double way, you know. What is my mother doing? What is my father is doing? How they talk, how they walk. They are observing also. The same thing here. What is our way? Behavior in gentleness, if we are gentle or not, or maybe we are very easy to irritate, maybe we are very easy to complain. As we keep in the mind that Lord is near, we will experience restlessness. In Lord, we will rest. The opposite of this quality is someone who argue a lot. So who are you with family? So what are we with family? Are we peoples? Are we like that? Or we are someone that the family member like to be with us. A family member, no, he is mature. If I will tell something, he will not get immediately panic. He will not get immediately angry. Okay? Are you patient and gentle and source of encouragement? Are you creating encouragement in your family, in your community, in your friendhood? So this is what the question is asking. Let's see the scripture. Philippians 4:5. Let everyone see that you are considerate in all you do. Remember the Lord is coming soon. Okay, here again the Paul is telling, okay? Do in a way, okay, in a careful way, that you don't hurt people, okay? That you don't hurt people who are the people who are powerless from you, even those the people who are the powerless with you. Okay, remember the Lord is coming soon. Now in Matthew 11:28-29, come to me to all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. Okay, take my word, take my yoke, take my word upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Okay, amen. Now, without worry and anxiety, remember that God is in control. Okay, three things I have: gentleness, without worry and anxiety. Now, okay, remember that God is in control. We are told to be always be anxious for nothing, because we can pray to God instead and to be anxious. We have to pray to God. In Philippians 4:6-7, it said, don't worry about anything, instead pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank Him for all He has done. The thing is that we have to thank Him also for what He has done in past and what He is doing now, and we have to thank in future. For the future also we have to have trust. God, thank you so much. I know, God, if it is your will, then it will be happen. Tomorrow, Lord, it will be happen if it is your will. If it is not my will, that is the prayer, the way God wanted us to tell in the way. So now, thank Him for all He has done. Then you will experience God's peace, which exists anything we can understand. His peace will guard your hearts and minds as you live in Christ Jesus. In Philippians 4:6-7. Number three, the last, but having subscriptions. Okay.
I will do.
Okay.
Because God is near, we should able to say, thank you, Lord. Instead of praying, peace of God will guard our hearts in Christ Jesus. When we pray for our concern and thank God for His blessing, the peace that comes from God surpasses all comprehensions. As our Heavenly Father, God will take care of us, and He will resolve our worries and fears. Be comforted by the fact of His nearness, just as a fearful child is comforted by the presence of their parents. As you go through life, God is with you. He is beside you. That's why we cannot stop being anxious. Our job is to pray and Habakkuk. It's an encouragement that we can still choose to rejoice in the Lord even we are facing problems. Let us do the same. There is reason to rejoice in God's presence, and our joy and security is grounded in the faithfulness of our tired and tested God. Jesus has always been and will always be the greatest comfort for those who are truly His. May our commitment to Him grow deeper as we choose to stand firm.
Amen. Now we go to the scripture. So, Sister Ruby.
After that, men from Moab went from Ammon and some other people called, Munites came to fight Jehoshaphat. Some men came, they said to Jehoshaphat, a large army is coming from the side of Syria. It has come across the Dead Sea to attack you. They are already in Hazon Tamar. That is another name for Engedi. Jehoshaphat was afraid, so he decided to ask the Lord what he should do, and he told all the people in Judah that they should not eat for some time. All Judah's people came together to ask the Lord for His help. They came from every town in Judah to meet the Lord.
Okay, here. Did this one, okay, the Jehoshaphat, okay, this was a king, so do he is planning or he is trying to control anything else? No. Instead of that, what he is doing, he is coming to the Lord. He is trusting the power of the Lord, and he is trusting the control of the Lord. So this is what we have to do also in our life. Similarly, okay,
This one? He said, pay attention, all you people of Judah, residents of Jerusalem, and King Jehoshaphat, this is what the Lord says to you. Don't be afraid and don't panic because of this huge army, for the battle is not yours, but God's. Tomorrow, march down against them as they come up the ascent of seas. You will find them at the end of the ravine in front of the desert of Jeroel. You will not fight in this battle. You take your position, stand and watch the Lord deliver you. O Judah and Jerusalem, don't be afraid. Don't panic. Tomorrow, march out toward them. The Lord is with you.
Amen. So, very important part. For the battle is?
Not yours.
But God's. The coronavirus, everything, the control, this is not our battle, right? What we can do instead of taking so much stress, so much panic, so much this one complaining, getting irritated, okay? Devil also coming, we just keep this is good, okay? Instead of that, we have to understand this battle is not ours. This is God. God is there, okay? And God is the one who will do according to His will, okay? We have to do is what? We have to take position only. Stand firm, take position means what? Do nothing. He's telling what? God is telling to him what? Do nothing. You take position. Because everything I'm the one who will do. You just take position only. So God is asking us to stand firm. Do nothing.
Stay at home.
Okay? Stand firm. Trust in the God, okay? Don't try to make a plan. Okay? Don't try to make a plan with the people. If I will do like this. Okay? So everything you do, you think to do also, surrender that in the hands of the God and you stand firm in the God. Reminding yourself, this is not my battle, but this is God's. Okay? Know that God is always with me. I will not be shaken, for He is right beside me. No wonders my heart is glad and I rejoice. My body rests in safety. You will show me the way of life, granting me the joy of your presence and the pleasures of living with you forever. In Psalms 8, 9, and 11. Okay. So we are here now. Okay. So we are in discussion questions. Okay, so we can now see the discussion question, okay? So any question, any one question, you can tag, okay? So you can start from, or you want to later, then I will go answer skip.
We'll read first.
Sir, please read, I will drink water also.
We'll prepare first.